I'm working on a new robot where I want to explore a new wheel design called a differential swerve drive. For my robot, I want a wheel that can spin both around its horizontal axis and rotate around its vertical axis, and the swerve does this. With my previous robot, I could do the same motions. Each of the six wheels could both spin and rotate. It allows the robot to drive in any direction without rotating the main body of the robot. In my case, where I use a camera for controlling the robot, this is quite handy as I can keep it looking in the same direction even while it's driving sideways. But there's a limitation in the way I designed this. As you can see, I have the driving motor inside the wheel, and therefore I'm running all the wires from the motor inside the rotating joint, and that limits its rotation. In practice, I could do around 220 degrees of rotation before the wire would jam. I was also limited by the servos I used, as they had about the same angular limit. The new swerve design solved this problem by having motors that remain stationary. Only the wheel will move around, not the motors. So in this design, I won't have any problems with the wires, no matter how many times the wheel rotates. Most of the parts are 3D printed, and you can find a link to the design files in the description below. In addition to the 3D printed parts, I'm also using some bearings, an axis, and of course a wheel. The wheel is mounted on the axis and it will have a gear in one end. To position the rim on the axis, I use a spacer with a hex shape that attaches to the rim and an embedded nut in the other end to fix it to the axis. Between the spacer and the gear, I put ball bearings. Next, the axis is mounted on a base using two brackets. Those are fixed with the same bolts that would also hold the bearings for the larger gears. I start by mounting three of the bearings because the gear has quite a tight fit, so to get the last one in, it must be positioned on the base before the bolt is inserted. The next part is the frame that holds the motors. For my actual robot, I will integrate this into the frame of the robot, so the one I have here is just a mock-up. It is not quite strong enough to always hold the motors in the correct position, so, well, I will have to redesign it for the robot. The part I show here I just used to check that all of the sizes in my drawings were correct, and it also allowed me to make some tests with actual motors, which you will see in a moment. This is the final assembled design. One motor is rotating the lower gear, and the other is rotating the upper gear. Okay, let's see it in action. First, I power up the motors so that they run at the same speed. This makes the wheel rotate vertically, but it doesn't spin. This is because the upper and lower gear rotate in the same direction. Now, if I reverse the voltage of one of the motors, you will see that the wheel will start spinning, but it doesn't rotate. And here you can see that the upper and lower gear rotates in opposite direction. Then if I disconnect one of the motors, I will get both a spin and a rotation. So by adjusting the speed and the direction of the motors, I'm able to control both the spin and the rotation. The way this works is easiest to see by looking at the middle gear. If the larger gears are rotating in the same direction, the middle gear can spin and is forced to follow along. If the larger gear rotates in opposite direction, the middle gear will spin and remain stationary. Here you can see how the middle gear moves between the two larger gears. And if I lower the speed of one of the motors with my finger, I'm able to rotate the wheel while maintaining the spin. So I can do any combination of spin and rotation. For my robot, I plan to use three of these wheels. I just wanted to try out one first, before making the drawing for the entire robot. But it does seem to work just fine, so I will continue with the drawings.